Last time you were on the show, you were, I believe, fresh out of Heavy Machinery. You were the yes. Otis, the fun-loving, stakes and weights, silly, over-the-top character. And it brought you some success, but this is a completely different Otis. And I talk about it on commentary week after week, the metamorphosis that we have seen in you as a competitor, as a character on screen. How has Chad Gable helped you develop into who we see on Monday nights now?
It's kind of crazy. Like the first night we actually were on a backstage where I just got done wrestling a match. We walked in the back and the first time Gable talks to me, I just realized in my head, I was like, oh dude, for being really close, that's our first time on TV together. We're starting to, you know, get our stuff in with the backstages and slowly building. And basically, you know, when Gable's mad, I know it. When I'm mad, he knows it. So we know when to, like, you know, if he wants to get me going, you know, in the backstage, and he only goes like, you know, think of this, think of that, you know, we're gets you mad in the past. So we go out to the ring there, you know, I'm thinking those things, and that helps me because now I'm trying to get a little nastier, a little saltier when I go out there. So yeah, it is a completely different Otis. I'm having a great time though. I mean, really, like me and him, because we, you know, we spend probably 16 hours a day with each other every day on the road. I don't know the math on that, but like, anyway, then we're neighbors. So I go, hey dad, I'll text him and go, hey dad, when are we training? We're the night before. And he's like, let me check their dues. The kids, the wife, yeah. Gymnastics. What do you got going on? I got this, brother. I got a massage at 4, 10:30 then. 10:30, yeah, 10:30, let's do it. 10:30, you know, what's in butts. I'm always late by a couple of minutes just because the dogs have to always go outside before I got to go. But yeah, it's like legit just a big-time friendship, like even like close as family. Like, because I'll go there, I'll see the kids running around. I'll run, you know, like we haven't wrestled them yet because, again, they're scared of me.
Because you're a giant human being, Otis.
And when he says we know when each other's mad, that's very true. And if anyone happened to be at the if anyone listening to this happened to be at the Baltimore car rental about 3 months ago, you would have seen us both mad at the same time because we got in our first public argument in the middle of the car rental facility over something we don't need to go into. But you would see in Chad Gable and Otis standing there in the middle of about 100. It was the busiest car rental I'd ever seen for some reason that day.
As you're describing this, I'm envisioning Planes, Trains, and Automobiles
right now. Exactly. Yeah,
where Steve Martin's just throwing the tickets. Yeah. And
I've got the finger out, and yeah, he's got the finger out at me, and he's beat red, and everybody, there is 150 people just like, what is happening here? And he looks exactly like he looks right now, you know, and you can about imagine. But we settled down, we grabbed an Uber together, we got back to the hotel together, and we worked it out.
I was picturing Doze, you with a cooler full of hard-boiled eggs, and Chad saying, absolutely not. You are not eating all those and getting in this rental car.
I do remember looking, because it was kind of like I had went to go. The intense conversation was happening. I turned to grab the handle because he goes, let's get the Uber. He starts sprinting. I grab my bag, and this lady looks so terrified. You know, she just went, oh. Like, are you gonna explode there, dude? Is basically what she said. And I go, I'm already exploded, lady.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.